Hello everyone, welcome to the second part of this lecture video on ketogenic diet. In the previous video, we studied about the general introduction of keto diet and the mechanism of it. Now, in this video, we will discuss the several application as well as the pros and cons of following the ketogenic diet. So let's get started. There are various practical and under-research applications of ketogenic diet in epilepsy, metabolic syndrome, glycogen storage disease, polycystic ovary syndrome or diabetes. Now, epilepsy is a disease that causes seizures due to excessive brain activity. Ketogenic diets have been shown to reduce seizure frequency and severity in many children and adults with epilepsy who don't respond well to the drug therapy. Now, metabolic syndrome, which sometimes referred to as pre-diabetes, is characterized by insulin resistance and various symptoms like elevated triglycerides, high blood pressure, elevated fasting blood sugar, etc. Ketogenic diets may reduce the abdominal obesity, triglycerides, blood pressure, and blood sugar in people with metabolic syndrome. Now, people with glycogen storage disease or GSD lack one of the enzymes involved in storing glucose or blood sugar as glycogen or breaking down the glycogen into glucose. Typically, this disease is diagnosed in childhood. Symptoms vary depending on the type of GSD and may include poor growth, fatigue, low blood sugar, and an enlarged liver. People with certain types of glycogen storage disease may experience a dramatic improvement in symptoms while following a ketogenic diet. However, more research is still needed. Next, we have the polycystic ovary syndrome or PCOS, which is a disease marked by hormonal dysfunction that often results in irregular periods and infertility. One of its hallmarks is insulin resistance, and many women with PCOS are obese and have a hard time losing weight. Women with PCOS are also at an increased risk for the type 2 diabetes. Now, the women with PCOS who are following a ketogenic diet may experience weight loss, reduction in insulin levels, and improvement in reproductive hormone function. Next, we have the people with diabetes often experience impressive reductions in blood sugar levels on a ketogenic diet. This is true for both type 1 and type 2 diabetes. Now, the next few applications of ketogenic diet is in treating some cancer, autism, Parkinson's disease or PD, obesity, and then we have the GLUT1 deficiency syndrome. Animal and human research suggests that ketogenic diets may benefit people with certain cancers when combined with other therapies. Although it may not have a significant impact on disease progression in advanced and terminal cancers, the ketogenic diet has been shown to be safe in these patients and potentially improve the quality of life. Now, autism spectrum disorder or ASD refers to a condition characterized by problems with communication, social interaction, and in some cases, repetitive behaviors. Early research suggests that some people with autism spectrum disorders may experience improvements in behavior when ketogenic diets are used in combination with other therapies. Next, we have the Parkinson's disease or the PD, which is a nervous system disorder characterized by the low levels of the signaling molecule dopamine. The ketogenic diet has shown promise in improving symptoms of Parkinson's disease in both animal and human studies. However, high quality research is needed in this area. Next, which is the most important topic in the ketogenic diet, is the removing the obesity. Studies have found that ketogenic diets are very effective for weight loss in obese people. This is largely due to their powerful appetite suppressing effect. Next, we have the glucose transporter 1 deficiency syndrome or GLUT1 deficiency syndrome, which is a rare genetic disorder which involves the deficiency of a special protein that helps to move blood sugar into the brain. Symptoms usually begin shortly after the birth and includes developmental delay, difficulty with movement, and sometimes seizures. The ketogenic diet has been shown to improve seizures and other symptoms in children with GLUT1 deficiency syndrome. The next few under research applications of ketogenic diets includes in traumatic brain surgery, multiple sclerosis, non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, Alzheimer's disease, migraine headaches, etc. Now, animal study shows that a ketogenic diet improves outcomes in rats fed a ketogenic diet after traumatic brain injury. However, there are currently no quality human studies in this. Multiple sclerosis or MS damages the protective covering of nerves, which leads to communication problems between the brain and the body. Studies about the potential benefits of a ketogenic diet for treating MS are promising. However, more human studies are still needed in this area. Non-alcoholic fatty liver disease or NAFLD is the most common liver disease in the Western world. And there's evidence that NAFLD also improves on a very low-carb ketogenic diet. Next, we have the Alzheimer's disease, which is a progressive form of dementia, characterized by plaques and tangles in the brain that impair memory. Interestingly, Alzheimer's disease appears to share features of type 2 diabetes. It has the symptoms like seizures, the inability of the brain to properly use glucose, and inflammation resistance. Several symptoms of Alzheimer's disease have been shown to improve with ketogenic diets in animal research. More prominent human research are still under progress. Last, we have the migraine headaches, which is typically involve the severe pain, sensitivity to light, and nausea. Some studies suggest that migraine headache frequency and severity may improve in people following a ketogenic diet. Now, after considering these applications previously, the possible pros of ketogenic diet would be include in treating epilepsy, weight loss, type 2 diabetes, cancer, and PCOS. There are some negative side effects of a long-term ketogenic diet which have been observed and suggested by several dietitians and research. Now, we can face the nutrition deficiency if we follow the ketogenic diet because whole food groups are excluded. Nutrients typically found in food like whole grains and fruits that are restricted from the diet can lead to deficiency, especially if the diet is followed incorrectly or without proper guidance. It is vital to incorporate a wide variety of foods while eating such amount of fat. Next, we have the keto flu. What happens during a diet transition, you may experience uncomfortable side effects from significantly cutting carbs, which is sometimes called the keto flu. Hunger, headaches, nausea, fatigue, irritability, constipation, and brain fog may last days. Sleep and hydration will help, but it may not be a pleasant transition into the diet. Adherence is very important when following the ketogenic diet. Point blank following a high-fat diet may be challenging to maintain from most. Keeping yourself satisfied with a limited variety of food and food groups and not being allowed to have some of the most pleasurable foods like fruits, rice dishes, ice cream or cream-based groups may be challenging to maintain a healthy lifestyle. This is very individual, but adhering to healthy diet is important. To truly gain long-term health benefits, one must have healthy habits in place year-round, not just 30 days at a time. Gut health is very important for ketogenic diet because using the restroom may be difficult since removing the whole grain and fruit would greatly lower one's fiber intake, so which is not great for the gut health. Last but not the least, there are a few points which we need to remember while following the ketogenic diet. Always consult the dietitian and health expert. Never start this diet on your own. Take it as a temporary diet, say from 1 to 3 months, not more than that. There are further researches going on about its application on complex diseases. Ketogenic diet is an additional benefit. This is not a complete cure for any of the disease. Hope you have liked this video. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel.